έγινε τόσο φιού για να το κρατήσει. Δεν άλλωστε πάλι
God said, ye shall be holy, for I am holy.
Is it God? Jesus Christ. You cannot get holiness from any other place. In this world that we are in, there are many things you can achieve by yourself. You can go to university, you go to school, you come up with a degree. In every discipline, you have Jesus. You give your certificate. You can decide to do business. You can decide to do anything. And you'll be able to get that. But holiness is not what you can attain by yourself. And actually, holiness is not an achievement. You cannot achieve holiness.
Caracteristic that when you just see a product, you know, this is
Like, what is the capital? What is the trademark of the capital? Is that? Is that very well? It has a trademark of the trademark. When you see the way they write the capital, you know it's a brand. It's a trademark. You can see a bottle with half trim, black, like that, but it's not purple. It can be like that. The color will look like that. When you look at it, you see the way they write it is their trademark. So it is there. So every product has its trademark. You know this is this trademark. You are a citizen of Nigeria. How can you prove that you are a citizen of Nigeria? What is your trademark? He said, let's give Jesus a hand for us. Wonderful. He said, your prayer certificate. That is very important. Your prayer certificate. How can I prove that you are a citizen of Nigeria? You bring me to your prayer certificate. Because it's your prayer certificate that shows that you are a native. Yourself. Nigeria is your place of birth. They call it native. What's it called?
Nativity.
Nativity. You know, nativity comes from your native. That's what is your native. Are you getting it? Nativity. Your place of native. So you see, what is your origin? The common we are familiar with, you say your local moment of origin, isn't it? Your state of origin, your local moment of origin. You have to go and bring a letter to show a certificate, a license to show. So when they see it, she gets. They still want to see your certificate, even with the Nigerian passport. So what shows the travel that you have the proof is the birth certificate. It's still way for the sense. The trademark of all Christians. How do you know someone is a Christian? The person who tells you is a Christian. How do you know? What is the proof? You bring your birth certificate. What is the birth certificate of the Christian? The birth certificate, that's the Jesus of the purpose. I can see everyone here is going to be filled. They are just getting all the answers. The Holy Spirit, the Holy Ghost, is the certificate. Romans 8, verse 9. Let's go and read that for us. Romans 8, verse 9. Anyone who has not received of Christ in him, it's not rich for you to be a Christian. For you must have the Spirit of Christ in you. Romans 8, verse 5.
But ye are not in the flesh.
Now listen. For ye are not in the flesh,
but in the Spirit.
But in the Spirit.
If so be that the Spirit of God dwell in you.
If so be that the Spirit of God dwell in you.
Now, if any man have not the Spirit of Christ.
Now, when Christ enters you, 6, verse 19 and 20. So we must always have that in our mind. That you are a holy person, you are a holy person. Why? Because the Spirit of Christ is here.
Know ye not that ye are the temple of God?
Now listen. Say, know ye not that ye are the temple of God?
And that the Spirit of God dwelleth in you.
That the Spirit of God dwelleth in you.
If any man defile the temple of God,
if any man defile the temple of God,
Him shall God destroy. For the temple of God is holy. Which temple ye are.
See? So God is in you. The indwelling Spirit of God is in you. That makes you holy. Read 1 Corinthians 6, 19 and 20 for us, okay?
What? Know ye not that your body is the temple of the Holy Ghost?
Know ye not that your body is the temple of the Holy Ghost? So when you see somebody say, I'm a Christian. So if it's any wrong for you to be a Christian, and I ask that person, are you holy? A Christian will not say, no, I'm not holy. You are not holy. They are not a Christian, not a Christian. You are not a Christian. Because Christians are holy people. Jesus. breakthrough is a must. We must be moving. We must be moving. We are moving because God has commanded us to be moving. Number one. We are moving because the Spirit of God is in us. It is those God has said, have commanded. If God says you're holy, you become holy. If he says no, you're not holy, you're not holy. It is only those who say that you're holy, you know that holy. And everyone who has chosen, you are holy. Once you choose, once you call you, you become holy. And this you can see in 2 Peter, in 2 Timothy. 2 Timothy 1, verse 9. That is what you can read from 2 Timothy 1, verse 9. He said, who has sent us and called us unto a holy calling? Not according to our works, not according to our purpose.
One verse nine.
Now listen, who has saved us
and called us with a holy calling?
You see, the calling was holy. I told you when God speak, He called us with a holy calling. Yeah.
Not according to our works.
Not according to the works.
But according to His own purpose and grace.
Thank you. Our work is not holy. It is not work that His purpose and grace they are holy. Continue.
Which was given us in Christ Jesus.
Which was given
before the world began.
Thank you very much. You see, now everything has been planned, concluded, seen and delivered. And also, we are seeing in Ephesians 1 verse 10, he said, we are seeing the Spirit of promise. So, now having this, it makes this easy for us. Because we have discovered. Revelation 22, 11 and 12. Let's see what the word of God is saying. Everybody is begging you there. It's my pleasure to read it. 11 and 12.
Revelation
3. Yes.
12. He that is unjust.
He that is unjust. Let him be unjust. Let him continue.
And he that is rich is filthy.
He that is filthy.
Let him be filthy.
Let him be filthy. Continue to be filthy.
And he that is righteous.
He that is righteous.
Let him be righteous.
Let him be righteous still.
And he that is holy.
And he that is holy.
Let him be holy.
Let him be holy still. Does it sound like somebody begging you? He said, do as you like. If you want to be holy, be holy. If you don't want to be holy, be holy. As you like. If you want to be righteous, be righteous. If you don't want to be righteous, continue. If you want to be dirty, be fine. Continue. So it's not begging you. It's not begging you. So you see, so holiness is the trademark of Christianity. It is something we cannot do without. So we must always have that in the back of our mind. It's a very strong, it's one of the most powerful virtue of God. God has many virtues. Righteousness is a virtue. Holiness is a virtue. Goodness, all these are the good things about God. But one of the most powerful, and that is what you see, the seraphims, the angels of God, in Isaiah, they continue to sing, holy, 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 because holy is too important. Let's look at it. Look at that. Read Isaiah from Isaiah 6, verse 1 to 3. As we begin to close, as I see one of them, it is in that we don't want to be holy. If Jesus Christ is holy, every one of us will be holy. That is the trademark of Christianity. It's the hallmark of Christianity. As I see.
Holy.
Woo!
And that it should be holy,
you must be holy.
And without
Let's mark it up. 1:20-21. Say, God will reconcile us.
And having made peace through the.
Now listen. You see, we are angry with God. Every one of us that is a sinner will be the kingdom of God. And in Colossians 1:13, we are translated from the kingdom of God to the kingdom of fears. Now, he having made peace. Now listen to what she should say.
Through the blood of his
cross. By him.
To reconcile all things unto himself.
To reconcile all things unto himself.
By him I say. Whether they be things in earth.
Or things in heaven.
And you that were.
Sometime alienated.
And enemies in your mind.
By wicked works.
Yet now,
we have seen as before, but now he has reconciled us.
In the body of his flesh.
True death.
To present you holy.
Which one is that?
Heaven.
Heaven. You can do that job.